So a week ago, we learned that several Republican lawmakers were texting with Mark Meadows after the 2020 election, talking about ways to overturn it, begging Mark Meadows to give them talking points, and then, of course, demanding that he show them some evidence of fraud, which he ultimately couldn't do, and that pissed the lawmakers off. One of the lawmakers, of course, was Republican Senator from Utah, Mike Lee. And in his text message, he specifically asked Mark Meadows, tell me what I ought to be saying. Like, literally begging Mark Meadows, tell me what I'm supposed to say out here. I don't know. I can't think for myself. I'm a Republican. Okay, I added that last part, but, you know, you can infer that. So Mike Lee, after a week of just trying to lay low and not discuss this, finally came out and offered the most pathetic defense possible for those text messages he sent to Mark Meadows. Here's what he said. He knows that when I say things like, tell me what we ought to be saying, what I was just trying to figure out was, what's your message? He knows me well enough to know that that doesn't mean that I'll do your bidding, whatever it is. You know, conversations I had with him at the time on the phone and in person, he knew that. He knew I was not there to do his bidding. You literally begged him, tell me what I ought to be saying. Now, does that to you, viewer, seem like, hey, you know, what's your talking points on this? You know, I'm just trying to figure out where you're at. Or does it seem like a man desperate to go out there and spread propaganda? Because to me, it kind of seems like the guy really wants some propaganda. Now, as I've said, because again, we did talk about this story earlier in the week, Mike Lee and then Chip Roy from the House was the other individual who was texting. Both of them did demand evidence, like as this went on. Of course, it did appear via the text messages, you know, what we can infer from that they were all in on trying to overthrow the election. And then as time went on, as Mark Meadows continuously, repeatedly failed to give them the evidence that they had been requesting, they both backed off it. They're like, well, we can't do this. You got nothing, basically. So I do, by the way, give them credit for that. And honestly, when you kind of, and I'm not trying to defend them here, and I know it's going to sound like it a little bit, but in the beginning, when you're being told by everybody else that, hey, there was fraud, this isn't legit, we got to do something here, and you're like, oh, really? Okay, wow, what do we do? Yeah, show me some of the fraud, by the way. No, you don't want to see it. No, actually, I really do. I mean, you know, it's been a couple weeks, like I need to see this or else I'm not going to keep saying these things. So they did evolve as it became clear that they were being lied to. So again, what they did is inexcusable, but you do have to give them a little credit for understanding in the end that one, there was no fraud, and two, not continuing on with those talking points once they learned the fraud was imaginary. You know, you got to celebrate the small victories where you can, right, folks? Because we don't get very many of those. We have seen far too many Republicans out there who know it wasn't stolen, but still go out there and say the same things that, oh, there was fraud, it was stolen every day. And at least these two guys didn't do that. You know, they're still kind of hesitant to admit that Biden legitimately won, but at least they wised up before it got too late. That doesn't excuse what they did. I still think they should be investigated. I still think they're a big part of the plot. And they should be involved in any indictments that come down the pipeline. And if your best excuse, as Mike Lee said this week, is that, oh, I was just, you know, I'm not doing his bidding. I was just texting him with a buddy. If that's the best you got, yeah, any legal case against you is going to go very well, just not for you.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.